the Philippines logged 4,405 new COVID infections on Monday. Active cases stand at 57,763, the lowest since July 29. The positivity rate has also gone down to 9%, the lowest in over 7 months or since March 8. The health department says the country is now considered low risk in terms of COVID-19 cases. The hospitalization bed utilization rate is also low, while ICU occupancy is moderate. But the World Health Organization reiterates there should still be no room for complacency.
I'm very happy to see the number of cases going down in the Philippines, and not only in the Philippines, but several countries in our regions. But as I mentioned, that the virus is really widely now entrenched around the world, so we should anticipate this virus would continue to surge within the countries. We're now working with the countries across the Western Pacific to plan for endemic COVID-19 with a focus on protecting the vulnerable and avoiding the red line where health services get overwhelmed.
The WHO also warning about the continued mutation of the coronavirus. Just yesterday, the Philippines detected more COVID variants of concern. Aside from the Alpha, Beta, and Delta variant, the Philippine Genome Center said one sample contained the B11318 variant first detected in Mauritius. It is considered a variant under monitoring. The patient is a 34-year-old male who returned to the Philippines from Saudi Arabia last March 5 and recovered from the respiratory illness on March 21.
The Philippine Environment Department has banned children below 12 years old from entering the Dolomite Beach in Manila Bay. That's after tens of thousands trooped to the beach on Sunday. The DNR says while it welcomes the public's interest in its Dolomite Beach project, Metro Manila is still under alert level 3. The health department earlier said the overcrowding of people in the tourist spot was a violation of rules set by the country's COVID-19 task force. Some also criticized the government for its inconsistency in implementing health measures.
Sinabi rin natin na kapag ka nakikita natin na crowded na, may gathering na, hindi na dapat natin pinupuntahan. At ang ating mga ahensya, may responsibilidad kayo to prevent this mass gathering.
Alin ang mas mahalaga? Yung dumalaw tayo sa ating mga mahal sa buhay na pumanaw na? O yung beach? Kung yung beach pwedeng payagan, bakit hindi pwedeng payagan ang pagdalaw sa simenteryo? Anong itinuturo natin sa mga bata?
The Philippines may begin administering booster shots for some priority groups in the next few weeks. The COVID Interagency Task Force is set to discuss the recommendation of the Health Technology Assessment Council to give additional vaccine doses to health workers and immunocompromised persons this fourth quarter and for other eligible priority groups in 2022. Experts also picked which vaccine brands may be used as a booster based on the earlier vaccine a person has received. The health department has already approved the HTAC recommendation. But the Food and Drug Administration still has to amend the emergency authorization it granted for the existing jabs.
Healthcare workers, we will allot more or less 2 million doses. And we have enough doses for them. Regardless of brand, meron po tayo na nakatabi. And then for the immune compromised and elderly, we will be requiring 5 million. And we have also enough doses with the succeeding deliveries. Most likely, we will start by November.
Naantay lang ho natin ang EUA. Pinagpaplanuhan na po yan and we will be informing the public in the coming days.